5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
There are two companies that put the applications and petition to start business of producing asphalt.
The question is, how long do you want to be exposed to this minor amount of chemicals that they really can't explain whether they are toxic or non-toxic? Because I've asked them.
I was at the board of supervisors meeting last night with Alex and the rest of us here when they indefinitely deferred the vote on the special use permit question. That was just for Findlay. The GRR one is still pending for June 23rd, as Alex mentioned. I just wanted to stress, guys, that this is 8 people, 5 of which need to vote this down. If that doesn't happen, it's a done deal. That's all there is to it. So June 23rd is important, unless that's indefinitely deferred. I just want to say, let's not peak too early on this thing. Let's not, by coming to this meeting, feel like you've done what you need to do and you're energized. I tell you, it's a quaint affair down there. It's at the Princeton and the county offices, if you don't know where that is. It's a quaint affair. This number of people in the parking lot there with signs prior to any vote would make a significant impact. But only if you've contacted them as well. They are actually responsive. By delaying the Findlay vote, that was just by a few emails and phone calls. Not a few, right, but I'd be curious. Who sent an email? I'm not trying to call them out. Okay, look at this. Good, okay. I wanted to leave you with that. That is key. 5 votes, okay?
It is true that we need to, the night of the meeting, or the supervisor's meeting, we need to pack the house. We need to have as many people as possible there and have as many people speak, be willing to speak as possible.
The one location, I think it's on Hornbacker, that one of the companies want to use, isn't that right immediately behind that new FBI building?
Yes,
it is
exactly where it is.
Okay.
There was a ban enacted in 1989 that prevented asphalt plants from being put into the area. That ban had to be lifted in order for these companies to set up a new business. My question is, when was that ban lifted? By whom? And what was the time gap between the lifting of the ban and the application of permits by these companies to do business in our area?
We have the resources and we just need to find them.